Welcome to the web tutorial, Merging PSID Records Part 2, Following Families Over Time. To begin, let's go over what you can expect to learn. This tutorial has three sections. We'll start by describing what it means to define a family in the PSID, followed by details about the most important variables for identifying individuals across time, and finally, we'll conclude by giving some examples on how to follow a family over time. A separate tutorial, Merging PSID Records Part 1, provides information on merging family-level information to individuals within a single year and following individuals across waves. Let's begin with an explanation of how to define a family in the PSID. In a single wave of the PSID, a family unit is defined as people living together on a permanent basis in a household who are either related by blood, marriage, or adoption, or are unrelated but are economically interdependent. The yearly family interview ID number indicates the family unit. This variable is available for every wave of data collection and is assigned based on the order in which the interviews are received. The first interview from the field is numbered 1, the second 2, and so on. This means it's very unlikely that a family will get the same family interview ID number in multiple waves. For this reason, the family interview ID number cannot be used to follow family units over time. The sequence number allows you to identify an individual's status with regard to the family unit and determine family composition change. Individuals currently in the family unit will have values from 1 to 20, while those in institutions, those who have moved, or those who have died between waves will have a sequence number in the range of 51 to 89. Starting with the 2017 wave, the term reference person has replaced head. The change in terminology is not retroactive, however, so when we refer to this individual in a historical context, we are still using the term head, or more likely head or reference person. Please see the video tutorial, Introduction to the Panel Study of Income Dynamics, for more information about this change. For each wave, then, the relationship to either head or reference person tells you how the individual is related to the head or reference person of the family. From 1983 to the present, 10 is always the head or reference person, 20 or 22 is a wife or spouse partner, other family unit members or OFAMs are coded as 30 and above, with children coded between 30 and 38, other relatives between 40 and 97, and other non-relatives as 98. Please note that from 1968 to 1982, the code frame of relationship to head was abbreviated, with a code of 1 for head, 2 for wife, 3 for children, 4 to 7 for other relatives, 8 for non-relatives, and 9 for husbands of heads. Whether sample or non-sample is a summary level variable that not only indicates individuals as sample or non-sample members, but also flags non-sample members who are designated as followable, including the non-sample parents of sample children. For a detailed explanation on sample status and following rules, please see the PSID user guide. The composition of a family may, and often does, change from wave to wave. Possible changes to these family units include, but are not limited to, adult children splitting off from their parents and establishing their own economically independent family units, families combining by moving in together or expanding through marriage or cohabitation or childbirth, and families separating through relationship dissolution, divorce, and death. All of these changes are tracked over time, shown here in the family composition change variable from 2013. Since the PSID is a genealogical sample, sample members are followed when they split off to form new family units. The split-off indicator tells you if a family has moved out of an existing PSID family unit to establish their own household. These new families have the same 1968 ID as the family they move out of, and keep the same 1968 ID each year. The main family ID for the split-off, along with the month and year the new household was formed, are all available for split-off families. In order to follow a family over time, one must first know how to follow an individual, then identify the family unit members of that individual over time, based on the definition of family that best fits the research question of interest. Whether you then decide to analyze individuals in those families, or reshape the individual-level data file to make a family-level file, depends on your research question of interest. Here we will guide you through making a file of individuals and family units of interest. Individuals are linkable across waves through their cross-wave unique identifier, as described in detail in the video tutorial, Merging PSID Records Part 1. This unique identifier consists of two variables, ER30001 and ER30002, or the 1968 ID and person number. Some statistical software programs let you specify two variables for merging. If you prefer to create a single ID for merging, you can multiply the 1968 ID by 1,000 and then add the person number, so each individual can be uniquely identified. The combination of the 1968 ID and person number is the same across all waves in which an individual appears, so it can be used to link data for individuals across years. If you use the data center to create an extract, individuals will be automatically linked for you across years. Note that an individual's person number may be changed by PSID staff, as new information is collected about their relationship to others in the study, and may therefore differ for a small number of cases from one release to the next. For the most accurate merges, we therefore recommend using the latest release available in the data center. Now that we have explained how to follow individuals over time, let's move on to following individuals within the same family units over time. First, select your baseline year to define all families at the starting point. For example, if we were looking at families from 1999 to 2005, we would use the family interview ID number in 1999 to define all family units present in 1999. Second, define the focal person or persons in the family that you will be following. Some research questions involve following the head or reference person. Others involve following couples, that is, the head or reference person and the spouse or partner. While some researchers follow children, irrespective of who the head or reference person is. Third, decide whether you will only follow the families that existed in the baseline year or include new families in the subsequent waves from split-off families. To illustrate how these decisions affect analytic file construction, let's take a look at a few examples. First, we will follow individuals and families who have no family composition change. Then, we will follow individuals and families who have the same head or reference person. A third example will follow individuals and families who have the same head or reference person and spouse or partner. Finally, we will explain how to follow the sample children of a family unit over time. Let's start by identifying families who have no change in family composition from 1999 to 2005. Here are three illustrative families. Families 1 and 3 keep the same structure in all four waves, without anyone moving in or out of the household, so they will be included in the sample. Family 2, however, experiences a divorce between 2001 and 2003. Since a change has occurred in the family unit during our specified time frame, they will not be included in our sample. In order to track which families have had no changes since the previous wave, use the family composition change variable in each wave. Here, a value of 0 means that no changes occurred to the family unit from 1999 to 2001. The same variable would be used from 2001 to 2003 and 2003 to 2005 to complete the panel. So, for the specified years, the sample would consist of individuals with individual sequence numbers in the range of 1 to 20 in family units with a family composition change of 0. In the second example, we'll follow families that existed in the baseline year, and the focal person will be the head. That is, in this example, we'll follow family units where the head stayed the same for each wave from 1999 to 2005. This could mean that children left the household during that time, as in illustrative family 1 in 2001, that a divorce took place, as in illustrative family 2 in 2003, or that no change in family composition occurred, as seen here in illustrative family 3. In all of these instances, the same head of household remained in all waves. To confirm that an individual's position in the family unit as current head or reference person of the household remained the same in each wave, in this example from 1999 to 2005, you need to check two variables, relationship to head or reference person and sequence number. To tell the current head or reference person from a mover-out head or reference person, use the sequence number from the individual file. The current head or reference person will always have a sequence number equal to 1, while a mover-out head or reference person will have a sequence number in the range of 50 to 89, depending on the move-out circumstances. If you fail to account for this additional information, it may look like you have more than one head or reference person in some family units. The sample would consist of individuals with sequence numbers in the range of 1 to 20, in family units where the head or reference person remained the current head or reference person in all waves. That is, with relationship to head or reference person equal to 10 and sequence number equal to 1. In the third example, we will follow families that existed in the baseline year and continue to have the same head and spouse partner, if there is one, from 1999 to 2005. This would allow for some family composition change, including children leaving the household as an illustrative family 1 in 2001, but would not include family 2, for whom a divorce took place between 2001 and 2003, since the spouse would no longer be in the family unit in 2003. This sample would also include female-headed households, seen here in illustrative family 3, where no change in family composition occurred over the time period. To follow families with no change in head or reference person, or spouse or partner, since the previous wave, use the family composition change variable. Here, a value of 0 or 1 means that either no change occurred, or that change occurred to family unit members other than the head or spouse partner in the family unit from 1999 to 2001. This same variable would be used from 2001 to 2003, and 2003 to 2005 to complete the panel. At the individual level, these head and spouse partners would be identified by using the relationship to head and sequence number variables, where the head or reference person and spouse partner would be coded as 10, 20, and 22, respectively, and their sequence numbers would be 1 and 2, respectively, in each wave from 1999 to 2005. In this example, for the specified years, the sample would consist of individuals with sequence numbers in the range of 1 to 20 in family units where a family composition change of 0 or 1. This approach identifies family units in which the head or reference person has a relationship to head or reference person of 10 and a sequence number 1, and the spouse or partner has a sequence number in the range of 1 to 20, relationship to head or reference person of 20 or 22, and a sequence number of 2. For the final example, let's follow sample children and their families, again from 1999 to 2005. Going back to our example families, you'll see that in family 1, not only will the two children who remained in the initial 1999 family unit be in the sample, but the adult son who moved out of the household in 2001 will be followed as well. So for the year 2001, that son would be considered a split-off, and each subsequent year, his family unit would be a re-interview family. As you can see, both family units continue to share the same 1968 ID, but would have different yearly family identifiers in each wave. In family 3, both children are in the sample and would be followed regardless of the divorce that takes place between 2001 and 2003. If they are sample children, the sample status of the parent they live with does not matter. The PSID will continue to follow them. To identify the sample children in 1999, a combination of three variables would be used. First, relationship to head or reference person would need to be in the value range of 30 to 38 to encompass all types of children. Second, in order to make sure they are currently members of the family unit, their sequence number would need to be in the range of 1 to 20. Third, they would need to be coded as a sample person. Their sample status ensures the fact that they will be followed, regardless of whether they split off to form their own family unit with another sample member or with a non-sample member. To identify split-off cases for 2001, use the split-off indicator. As previously mentioned, we also provide the month and year the new family unit was formed. You would repeat this process for waves 2003 and 2005 for this example time period, and then decide whether or not you want to keep the split-off families in your analysis based on your research plan. To summarize, in order to follow children, keep individuals in the baseline year with a relationship to head or reference person in the range of 30 to 38, and a sequence number in the range of 1 to 20. In order to be followable, they must also be sample members, as defined with a value of 1 to 3 for the summary variable, whether sample or non-sample. Having a value for sequence number in the range of 1 to 20 means that they are still in the sample in subsequent waves, and a decision will need to be made whether to keep split-off families when they are in a family with a split-off indicator equal to 2. When it comes to following families longitudinal in the PSID, there isn't one correct way to do it. Each researcher needs to decide how they wish to define a family and to specify which differences in family composition constitute a change in that definition. From there, it is a matter of using the identification variables in each wave to track individuals appropriately in order to create a sample of individuals in family units for the specified time period of interest. Finally, if the unit of analysis of interest is the family, the researcher may reshape the individual file to a family-level file for analysis. This web tutorial was produced by Nora Insulera and Vicki Friedman in collaboration with the Michigan Center on the Demography of Aging with funding from the National Institute on Aging. This ends the web tutorial on Merging PSID Records Part 2, Following Families Over Time. Comments and questions may be sent to psidhelp@umich.edu.